Welcome back. Today, we are going to draw some backgrounds from our dinosaurs. So if you remember from the book, there are lots of different ones. I'm going to show you how to draw a couple of them. I'm going to use a marker, and then we're going to move on and do a couple different backgrounds. Because you made a bunch of dinosaurs, you might as well make a bunch of different backgrounds for them and decide which one you want to go where. Okay? So the first one we're going to do is going to be a city. So we're gonna draw the city. When you're drawing a city, first you probably wanna have a road in the very front. Then you might wanna have some buildings. Now I'm using long rectangle shapes. You can also make some different shaped buildings. Maybe a building that's shaped like this. Notice I'm not making any of them the same height. Just like that. When I'm making the buildings, I like to give them different kinds of doors. Just like that. Then I like to give them different kinds of windows. Now there might be some buildings behind other buildings. Ooh, that's different. Giving them windows and roofs. And I've completely finished this one, unless I wanted to add a cloud or something like that in the sky. This is one completed background. That's a city. I'd like to make a house one. Like maybe he's helping out with some housework. So let's make the ground. That'll be where the grass is. Let's make the front of the house right here. Okay. Before we move on and do the rest of the house, let's put a couple trees in. Put some trees over here. It's always nice to have trees. Now we can put the rest of the house in. I'm gonna make it go off the page, which means we can add cute windows, window shutters. Maybe you're gonna make it like your house. I don't know. Maybe the front door, some stairs, and then maybe the sidewalk, and maybe you have a window here with some shutters, upstairs windows. Maybe you have one of those fences for privacy or so your dog doesn't get out in your picture. Okay, maybe let's do some of the grass to show that it's grass. Maybe this is your neighbor's house over here and this is the back of their roof. Windows. That one's ready. Let's do one that's got some water in it. So maybe I've got some water down here. Maybe there's some boats in the water. Maybe we have a bridge. And a bridge needs something to stand on. So I'm gonna make some bricks. So maybe my bridge goes way up high. Maybe the cars go across up here. Make that thick road. And then we need the supports. Support the bridge. And then maybe we could put some buses and some cars on it. And some buses and some trucks. Maybe a big old truck there. Then you have a nice bridge. Of course, you could always put some clouds in the background. Let's do a farm. So let's make the little barn way back here. Place where they put the grain. Now, to make the farm, so I'm gonna make different areas of land. So I'm gonna divide my page. This is gonna be the top of the land back here. And I'm gonna divide them all into different areas that can be farmed. So this is gonna be a row of some crops getting farmed. This is the planting season. They'd be putting the seeds in there. This one's gonna go this way. One might also go this way. For all the different kinds of crops that they're going to grow. Now this might have like a driveway there so they can pull up. Oop, I forgot to put this up there. This might have one of those weather things on the top. There might be some trees and bushes around here. Maybe just some grass. And then maybe we have some clouds off in the distance. We drew a farm one. Let's draw like inside of some place, like maybe a doctor's office. So we've got like, there would be some cabinets to put things in. We might have a window over here to see outside. Maybe some bushes. Maybe the sun out there. Maybe we'll have like a place for you to kind of lay back. Like a doctor chair or a dentist chair. You could put a patient on there if you wanted. Something like that. Maybe there's a place for some doctor tools and some cups and some shots and some things. A lot of times out of the ceiling, they'll have like a light to see better. Something like that. Oh, this might have a cabinet in it too, and it might be on wheels so they can roll it around. That could be in a place where you could put your dinosaur. What if your dinosaur is helping build some stuff? So we might want to start with like some stacks of building materials. And then maybe there's like a ground back here. Maybe make some more stacks, make it taller. And maybe we have like some buildings way off in the background. Like there's a city back here that's being built. It'll give some windows to those things. Maybe we have a structure that's being built and they're building it. So we've got like the structure here. It's being built. These are all those beams. Maybe this goes up a little higher and there's another beam up there. And maybe there are some trucks around here carrying some building things. And maybe there's a crane. And then the crane operator is in here. It's a little guy. And this that. And maybe there's some little guys here. Maybe there's a little worker guy who's kneeling down, fixing something with his special hard hat on. Maybe there's a little guy here who's sitting, gonna be doing something with his hard hat on. Maybe there's a little guy here working on something with his little hard hat on. There's a taller guy up here doing some work with his hard hat on. So there's a lot of stuff. Now I can continue drawing my city. In the background. And I'm giving it all the same kind of windows, because it's really far away, so we really can't see the details of the windows. All of the things we want people to be looking at are up close. I like to add a little about. And now you have a construction site where all the guys are working, building new things. I like to put little nails and things in there. I have one more idea. I want to do like a park. So I'm gonna have lots of trees. So I'm gonna start off with some trees, and I just make the trees like a big cloud and then give them some tree things. Some roots. Make another big tree here. Make my big cloud. This one's gonna go off the page, it's so big. And then I can make some ground. Want the ground to look like grass. And maybe there's some more trees in the background. So I'm gonna draw some trees that are overlapping. This is a park. Now, I like the bark to have some lines on it to make it look kind of barky and not smooth because it's very rough. Maybe there's a little kid back here and he's playing. Hat on, and he's flying a kite way up high. Woo, kite. I like to fly kites. Maybe there's a kite that's stuck in the tree. Maybe there's a kid down here who's kind of sad about that. With his little hat on. Pointing at it. I don't know. So there's a park. Oh, it's sunny. So I'm gonna put the sun and one little cute cloud back here. And then I did a park. Come up with your own ideas. Maybe you wanna make something that I didn't show you how to draw. The main thing is that you draw it with a pencil first. Then use a marker or a black marker or a black crayon. It doesn't matter if it's permanent or whatever, because we're not gonna color these. These are gonna stay black and white, just like in the book. So we're gonna make our pictures look like the book. So outline with the black marker when you're finished and erase your pencil lines. Tomorrow, we're gonna put it all together. I want the dinosaur.